Section 551071, paragraph 1 and 2 regarding the three lawsuits. I just need approval to move the agenda item from you all, and I'll make that in the form of a motion. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Any discussion from the members?
Yes. Do y'all request public comment before you go into executive session or out after?
We've been allowing a public comment before we go into, or before discussion or any votes that we've taken. So, yes, please.
Okay. So is now the time?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is number 11 regarding the suit for against the Attorney General, correct? I don't have an agenda on my person. But so real quick, for y'all that don't know, there was a PIA request that came in. They didn't want to answer, so their attorneys appealed to the Attorney General and said, hey, we don't want to answer this. Can we get a ruling that we don't have to answer it? And the Attorney General wrote back and said, you claim the remaining information consists of attorney core work product that is protected by the Texas Rule of Civil Procedures. Upon review, however, we find that you have not demonstrated the information at issue contains the mental impressions, opinions, conclusions, or legal theories of an attorney or the attorney's representatives that were developed in anticipation of legal for trial. Therefore, we conclude that the cooperation may not be held, the corporation may not withhold any of the remaining information under Texas Rule of Civil Procedure. So what the PIA request was asking for invoices, attorney invoices, no work product there. So I guess my question is why did this board not agree with the Attorney General and file a costly lawsuit without the consent of the board, without public notice, in violation, clear violation of TOMA? So, I suspect you won't answer this question, so I'll ask these rhetorically because I know you're not going to answer them anyway.
Well, you might.
Oh, you might? Are you going to answer?
So, if you'll give me a chance.
Oh, sure.
So, we're going to meet in executive session to talk about these items. I'm going to provide, that's what executive session is about, I'm going to provide our members with an update and briefing on what our attorney said. Pending that conversation, I'm going to come back and I have a statement. If it needs modifications, I'll make those modifications, but I'll read the statement about the matter that you've asked. But
okay.
But the key is that I need to discuss the matters with the board, and that's what I was moving to do.
Okay, perfect. So before I go into executive session, just a couple more questions. First of all, how much is it costing this association to sue the Attorney General? Because I heard that Double Horn Creek was holding a bake sale and a GoFundMe and some kind of
gala
to raise $400,000 for the lawsuit that they lost against the Attorney General. So just curious as to what we've spent to date and what we plan to spend in the budget for that. And then, quite frankly, what are so damning in these invoices that they cannot be shared with the PIA requester? The lawsuit you filed repeatedly states that it's because of ongoing litigation with TOMA. But if I understand correctly, that lawsuit was settled by an appeals court in July. So I don't know of any ongoing litigation with TOMA. Perhaps there's litigation with TOMA that I'm not aware of.
I'll answer that point. I mean, we're going to go into executive session to discuss that. There was a filing this week in the Supreme Court on that case.
Still open.
The discovery phase.
The discovery phase is over.
Civil rules of procedure. Civil rules of procedure is over.
That's all I'm going to say. All right. So let me read the rest of the. Anybody else want to comment on this?
Yeah. Who? What board members made the appeal or this lawsuit?
So,
with,
like I right, like I said earlier, we're going to go into executive session. We're going to discuss it. We're going to come back. If there are any modifications to what our attorneys have instructed us, we'll make those modifications. But we are going to read that to you all after
Are
this.
Are we allowed to ask questions after you read that statement to us?
Yeah. I mean, it's a consideration of our own. Sure.
I guess my question is, earlier you indicated that without this loan that you are embarking on, you would not have the ability to pay the balloon payment of $200,000, and now you're also embarking on a, I guarantee you that that's going to be a costly fight against the Attorney General.
Okay.
I'm not going to comment.
Any other questions or comments? I'm sorry.
Yeah, how much money has it cost already? How much money are you planning on?
Yeah, we're going to talk about it after we go into executive session. All right, so I need to read the rest of this agenda item. French et al. I made that in a motion that we'll meet in executive session, move this agenda item up, and everybody's in favor with that? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, so the executive session under Texas Government Code Section 551.071(1) and 2 regarding French et al. And intervener plaintiffs and Double F Hangar Operations LLC et al. V. Friendship Homes and Hangars LLC, Windermere Oaks WSC et al. Cause number 482-92, 33rd Judicial District, Burnett County District Court, and Toma Integrity Inc. et al. v. Windermere Oaks, cause number 47531, 33rd Judicial District, Burnett County District Court, on appeal at 6 Court of Appeals, number 0619-0005-CV, and item C, appeal of Attorney General ruling filed in Travis County Court in the case of WOWSC v. the Honorable Ken Paxton, Attorney General of Texas, for protection of corporate rights and privileges during ongoing litigation. Okay, so we will meet. We're going to conclude regular session and meet at 7:37 into executive session. All right, let's get this meeting reconvened. Mike, my watch shows 8:13 for the meeting. Mike, just tell me when you're ready to roll. That's yours. It's not mine. I've got the old. Okay. The agenda here is item number 12. Consider and or act on matters reviewed in the immediately preceding executive session agenda item. And we're reconvening at 8:13, 8:14, something like that.
Still working on setting up.
You're still working, Mike? Okay. I'll wait for your green light. Okay, so on this is no action, but I just want to give an update. Item B, 11B, Toma Integrity Inc. versus Windermere Oaks WSC. As I said, the Toma Integrity Inc. et al. Filed with the Supreme Court in the last few days. Our attorneys responded today with a letter saying we received the petition for review that you sent, and they're saying this to the Supreme Court, to the Texas Supreme Court. If you have any questions or would like for us to comment, we will be happy to do so. And that's a budget-saving effort on our attorney's part. Item number C, appeal of Attorney General ruling filed in Travis County Court. Here's the statement. This past May, WOWSC received a public information request that requested our legal invoices from the time period covering the entirety of WSC's lawsuit with Toma Integrity. At the advice of our attorneys and for the sole purpose of asserting privileges lawfully available to us to protect our position during litigation, WOWSC requested a ruling from the Attorney General that we could withhold these invoices under privileges while the lawsuit is ongoing. This August, the Attorney General ruled that while we may redact certain information within those invoices, the remainder must be released. Upon review of this ruling by our legal team, they determined that the Attorney General's office did not apply privileges to the full extent authorized by law, and that compliance with the AG's August ruling would put the WSC at a disadvantage during the remainder of the lawsuit with Toma Integrity. Pursuant to my authority as board president and public information officer, and at the advice of our legal counsel, I directed our legal team to file an administrative appeal of the August Attorney General ruling to protect the rights of the WSC while the lawsuit remains ongoing. This is not a new legal proceeding with the Attorney General, but rather an appeal of a staff attorney ruling in a matter now ongoing since May of this year. The WOWSC board remains in compliance with the Open Meetings Act and has followed the advice of its attorneys in doing so. I will not comment any further on the specifics regarding of pending litigation with Toma Integrity and the interrelated appeal of the Attorney General's ruling, as that is detrimental to our legal rights as a corporation, the parties involved, and the membership. The appeal involving the Attorney General is simply and solely to protect our position during the pendency of the underlying litigation with Toma Integrity. Were the request for privileged information to be withdrawn, the appeal of the Attorney General's decision would, of course, become moot. Any request for information that does not request privileged information, as has been the case with almost all of the 37 PIA requests submitted to the WSC this year, has been processed and will be processed without the involvement of the Attorney General. However, we cannot afford to jeopardize our legal position while the suit with Toma Integrity remains ongoing. The board certainly finds it unfortunate and regrettable that public dialogue is not productive, but of course every member should feel free to speak his or her mind as they see fit, and as always may speak at public comment at any open meeting of the board. That's our statement from our attorneys, and they assure us that we've heard comments about this Double Horn Creek thing, and that is completely 180 degrees from what is going on here. They have a much bigger lawsuit, and this is a very limited and finite, those were the words of the attorney, a limited and finite appeal of a previous decision protecting our rights as a corporation for attorney-client privilege. So,
well, should we get member comment first?
Is there any member comment?
So, yes. May I go?
Sure.
I think your statement from you and or your attorney is completely misleading. The title of your lawsuit is Original Petition for Declaratory Relief. That is not an appeal. You didn't like what they said, and you're suing them. So to tell us all that you're just making a little administrative appeal is misleading to this organization and our community. So I don't believe you when you say this is just an administrative appeal. It is a lawsuit, and you filed an original petition in a lawsuit. Yeah.
Janie?
I'm confused. They're asking for invoices. And they've said that you can take any type of information that's written, like a summary or whatever, out of it, correct? Is that what they said?
Keep going. I'm not quite following you yet,
okay,
but I will.
They're looking for an invoice. We paid this lawyer this much in this story. And that's what they're asking for. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am. That is correct.
No.
I've heard yes and no. What?
Legal bills are much more complicated than that.
It wasn't just the price we paid, right? Exactly. So
correct.
So these actions were provided in the PIA response, okay? And that wasn't, and so that is what is being contested.
So you gave them just the dollar amount and the invoice, and they said that wasn't enough?
No, they didn't know. I wasn't part of it.
The attorneys responded to the request with the redacted invoices. And so now it's they're saying, no, it's not enough, and that's where basically the illegal is, the legal team is saying, no, you go back now, and you say, yes, this is privileged information that's contained in those redacted amounts, in the redacted language. So we're following the advice of attorney.
He's making billions of dollars.
Correct. Correct. Okay. Any other comments? I'm sorry, ma'am, I didn't hear. What was it?
You don't always have to take an attorney's advice.
I mean, you're spending our money. I mean, you work for us. And you're spending our money just throwing it away. And if I had an employee like that when I was working, I'd have fired his ass. Anybody that is bad business. That's all there is to it.
That's it. That's all I want to say on the matter, but it ain't
so,
right.
So Jamie, I can explain it to you. It's in here. All the invoices were sent to the Attorney General. The Attorney General sifted through every invoice, marked out some stuff that they could keep from the requester, which is me, by the way, and said you have to hand over the rest. Their appeal, this was the appeal, and the Attorney General said, no, sir, give it to them. So they filed a lawsuit because they didn't like what the Attorney General said, and that's the facts.
Okay.
So, is that right?
And that's all standard. That's all standard appeals process.
No.
So it has a standard course it takes. It's fine.
It's not an appeal. You filed a lawsuit against the Attorney General.
Right. So here's the thing. If you disagree with the
court to get a court decision, we're not asking for money.
It's not an appeal.
If you disagree,
Toma never asked for a dime. Toma never asked for any money.
Okay. I'll just say this, and if you disagree with the Attorney General's decision, who do you appeal to? The Attorney General again? No. You appeal to a third party. In this case, it was Travis. It was Travis County Court.
Why would it be Travis County Court if we're in Burdick County?
That's where the lawyers filed it.
That's where the lawyers filed it.
Correct.
Okay. Next question. We're all members.
We can't always, and just so you know, we can't always answer every question.
Right.
I appreciate your comments, and we're trying to do the best we can, but for different reasons, especially the fact that we're under continuing litigation, we have to be very careful.
Hey, Joe. So, Jennifer.
I think she had the.
I just wanted to know if the board members knew that about this lawsuit that was filed in Travis County, the board members of the Water Corporation, these people.
So
you can't, are you doing no comment?
I'm not commenting right now.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And this is tit for tat, and I'm not on anybody's side here. I'm really just trying to become an informed community member, but shouldn't we hire attorneys that file in Burnett County because that's where we are? I mean, it doesn't seem like they really understand our community if they're filing in Travis County. And I'm just saying this because we do a lot, my husband and I do a lot of work in Travis County. The amount of money we spend just to get through the red tape in Travis County is insane. So I'm just saying, small town, small community, why wouldn't it just make more sense financially for us?
This board didn't hire these lawyers.
Okay, so here's are there any other
we
follow the advice of our attorneys. That's their decision.
So I'm just gonna put it out there. Maybe we need to look at getting a different attorney that knows our community a little more. That's
okay.
All I'm saying.
Thank you. Any other comments?
Did you get your answer?
Yes, sir.
I did not get an answer.
So the answer was contained in my statement. Pursuant my authority as board president, public information officer, and at the advice of our legal counsel, I direct our legal team to file an administrative appeal of the August Attorney General ruling to protect the rights of the WSC while the lawsuit remains ongoing. So, any other questions? And we've got something else that we need to get to if anybody has any other questions. Okay. So after the executive session and discussion, we're now considering a motion, I believe.
Yeah. I make a motion to approve the resolution and authorizing the continuing defense of the Water Supply Corporation's position of protecting attorney-client privileged information in response to PIA requests, including maintaining all pending appeals in court at the direction of the board president / public information.
A second.
We have a second?
Yeah, Bill seconded.
Okay. Any other, no discussion from the board? Okay, hearing none. Is there any comments from the members of the audience?
I don't expect the answer to this. I've been a party to lawsuits myself. What are y'all hiding in the invoices? It is not damaging your case. It may damage you personally, but it's not damaging your case to see the invoice.
That's your opinion.
And it's a damn good one.
Just to see an invoice.
Okay. So any other comments? Okay, hearing none, we're going to vote on the motion.